I like clouds. We need to be as accurate as we can.
Arms up.
Right here, we're gonna fill it up with helium. We're gonna launch it off into the atmosphere.
We're doing the same stuff as satellite. I know. How cool is that? Yeah.
There's a place I go for inspiration. Gotta get to the web, check the girl's investigation. What girl? SciGirl! Woo! SCITIRLS!
I need you!
SCITIRLS!
Come on!
You got log on, post, upload, pitch in!
Yeah!
Wanna get inside a world that's fascinating? The time is right, the SciGirls are waiting!
Hey, thanks for letting me borrow Fang for my 10-second film, Jake.
No problem. He's gonna pull out the most brilliant performance by a mouse in a lead role ever.
Yeah, Fang learns a trick. He's gonna take the short film festival by storm. Now let's actually teach Fang a trick. Come on, Fang. Go around the cups. Follow the stick. Or not. It's your show.
Genius talent like Fang's works in its own time. But let me try. You got this, Fang. You're the best mouse actor of our generation.
No. We need to make the stick more exciting than the cup.
My pants!
Huh?
I wore these pants for a month straight 3 months ago for National Cheese Eating Month. Mmm. Lint AIDS cheese. This should do the trick.
And it's Jake with the surprise performance. Here, Fang. I know you want this delicious lint-aged cheese. Yes!
That's my brilliant bud!
Go around the cups. Go on! Oh, this would be frustrating if he wasn't so cute.
Maybe the SciGirls can help.
Great thinking. I'll keep this short. SciGirls, help! This one just might do the trick.
Woo. Look at it.
Come on.
I know. All right, let her out.
Man, if we got in our swimsuits, we could fly our kites from the ocean.
I'm Lauren. I really enjoy going to the beach and doing hands-on things at the beach. You can surf, you can boogie board, you can swim in the waves, you can build sandcastles. Emma and Madison, I've known them since second grade.
Can you unhook the tail?
Yeah.
No, Emma!
Never mind!
I'm Emma. It's fun to just lay on the beach and to look up at the clouds.
That one looks like a lizard.
That one looks like a grizzly bear.
You'll never see the same cloud twice, but clouds are forever changing.
Hey, that cloud looks like a rabbit.
And you might see a bunny one time and then a turtle another.
Flying a kite with no hands.
My name is Madison. I like clouds because I've always found them fascinating. They're not very tangible, and so it makes them all more interesting to study them.
We made this morning.
We engineered a kite and we attached a camera to it.
Yeah, we recycled
an old soda bottle. And then we used a dowel and we stuck it through the waterproof case.
And used some pretty sturdy string to tie it all together.
All you have to do is hit record.
You ready, Lauren?
Yep.
All right. 1, 2, 3.
Woo! Awesome.
Say hi to the sky.
Hi.
Whoa, how high are you?
Got it.
All right, you can help
get
me.
My phone.
Yay! Awesome.
Bring on the clouds.
In class, we just finished our weather unit, and now we want to learn more.
Hi, ladies.
Hi.
Are you Emma, Madison, and Lauren?
Yeah.
Hi. My name's Yolanda. I'm a NASA research scientist who studies the atmosphere.
Ooh, nice.
Our teacher, Miss McDowell, told Yolanda about us.
I thought I would teach you guys more about clouds and the atmosphere so you guys can learn a little bit more.
Yolanda came to my house to tell us about school. School is a citizen science program at NASA.
School stands for Students Cloud Observations Online, so it's S-COOL. It's a NASA program where scientists try to get the help of students, so you guys would be called rovers.
Okay. Awesome.
What we need is ground observations of clouds so that we know how our satellites are doing.
There are two satellites, Aqua and Terra.
They take pictures and they observe the different types of clouds and also the different levels that they're at during a certain time.
We're looking at the Earth from two different perspectives. There's a satellite looking from space down on Earth, and we're looking from the ground up to space.
So these rovers go out at the same time period as the satellite, and then they take pictures and observe what the different types of clouds are.
And you take your observations, and then we can compare to the satellite to see how close your observations and the satellite's observations are. So it's important that we take our observations within 15 minutes of the satellite overpass.
Oh, we have to work quickly.
That's right. You think you guys can handle it?
I think so.
I think you guys can too. So I brought my laptop for us to check out the observation times.
We went to the school website to find out the overpass times of Aqua and Terra.
We can click on when to observe.
Okay.
And select the satellite that we'll be using. So we'll be using Aqua because it passes over in the afternoon. Okay. Yeah, I think that's when we'll be able to do our observation. Time that it's passing over is
1:29.
That's right, it is 1:29.
Okay.
Miss Yolanda drove us to the beach on a golf cart.
We made it!
I'm gonna try.
Yeah, that's one of the girls.
It
looks great!
What? On the beach, we learned school protocol.
We kind of have clouds that are on generally three different layers of the atmosphere.
The three layers, they're low clouds, they're middle clouds, and they're high clouds.
What can you tell me about stratus clouds?
They're low lying, like a thick blanket.
Yeah,
a layer, you know.
Okay.
I think I'm gonna go with stratus.
Stratus? Okay, so we're going flat and low,
flat and
right?
Cumulus.
What about cumulus clouds?
They're big, puffy, fluffy.
Yeah. And then what about cirrus clouds?
They're high and wispy, looking like little horse tails.
Icy particles.
Right, and they're made out of ice because they're high up.
Let's all be cumulus clouds.
Cumulus clouds.
When Miss Yolanda joined in our cloud dances, and I thought it was very unique that we had an actual NASA and school scientist joining in cloud dances. By doing dances and poses, it really helped the different cloud types to stick in my mind.
12 cloud types, go.
Cirrus, cirrocumulus, cirrostratus.
Contrails, altocumulus, altostratus.
Cumulus,
stratocumulus.
Cirrostratus, did I say that already?
Gosh. Stratus.
Cumulonimbus.
Nimbostratus.
Missing one.
Did I say fog? No, I didn't. Fog.
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 So are you guys ready to do your first school rover observation?
Yes, let's go.
Okay, how's the time looking?
So since we're measuring with the 24-hour clock, the hour is 1:16, so we're going to put 13 for the hour and 16 for the minute.
Okay, so we're within 15 minutes of our overpass time, which is what?
1:29.
Come up with rover nicknames. You guys are our rovers.
We could do Mel for Madison Emma Lauren.
The satellite was about to pass over, so we quickly filled out our report form.
Make sure we're looking straight above us.
School protocol is to make a V with your arms and only count and measure and observe the clouds that are inside that V.
Okay, so you can kind of cut out a circle with your arms. And that's your circle of observation.
Because that way we can ensure that the satellite is measuring the same clouds.
We measured cloud type.
I see some cumulus clouds.
Cirrus, altostratus, and altocumulus.
When we go back to back, if we have enough V's touching, we can create a circle of observation. So that way we can get the whole sky observed.
So total cloud cover is broken.
One of our observations that we take is sky visibility.
So this is our haziness.
I'd say it's somewhat hazy.
There are still little spots that you can see of the sky.
Yeah, we have to look out on the horizon. So what if we look at the pier over there?
Yeah. So I'd say somewhat hazy. I don't think it's too hazy.
Yeah, I think that's
You can see the sky through it.
Somewhat hazy.
Sure, that's good.
Okay.
And now sky color.
I think it looks more like a blue.
Yeah, this is a blue.
We used a sky color chart to figure out how blue the sky was. Okay, like so it looks like a blue, like a deep blue.
Yeah.
Or a blue.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
So we measured cloud opacity.
Cloud opacity is a measurement that we take to measure how much sun or light we can see through the cloud.
So we can put that down in our category.
We're gonna see a lot of airplanes passing by that create contrails.
So we have our ground observations at the bottom there.
Ground observations are what we view on the ground, like whether it's raining, if the ground is dry.
I'm feeling good. Great, I've never done this before, but it's really cool that we're doing the same stuff as satellite is.
I know.
How cool is that?
Yeah.
It's we're like
school.
We're like NASA girls.
Woo! We're NASA girls. NASA girls.
NASA girls.
Hi, I'm Madison. Welcome to my home at Virginia Beach. This is my dog, Samantha. I love to sing, and I like to play the guitar as well.
Tennis is a great sport.
Bye.
We took the observations from the beach, and then we went home to enter them onto the school website.
The cloud coverage went broken. Our sky visibility was somewhat hazy. The sky color was blue. The low-level clouds, it was cumulus. The cloud coverage was scattered. The temperature was 79 degrees Fahrenheit.
Ready to submit?
Yeah.
Drum roll.
Does everything look good?
Yeah, it looks great.
Yep. All right,
submit.
Yay.
Woo. Good job, ladies. You completed entirely your first observation.
Awesome job, guys.
Awesome, guys. It says, your observation has been entered into the school database. Ceres satellite data will be processed by Flash Flux in about a week.
Why does it take so long for the information from the satellite to get down to us?
What's taking a long time is the program is sorting through all of the satellite data and matching it to the observations that you guys took today.
Today, we are filling out another one of our report forms and observing the clouds at this time.
What time does the satellite come by?
At 10:54.
10:54. What time is it now? Let's check the... official time.
Right now it's 10:51, so we got this. All right.
All right, ready?
Official NASA
let's do this.
All right, guys, let's go. Into position.
Okay, here we go. Okay. Start with our high-level clouds. All right, let's do our V now.
V's.
I see a few cirrus clouds.
Yes. Not only was I having a fun day on the beach measuring clouds with my friends, I was benefiting science.
And it's not raining, so no nimbo clouds,
yeah.
No nimbo stratus.
I think it's on a personal level that was very cool for me.
So what were those other types of clouds?
For the high-level clouds, we saw cirrus and cirrocumulus.
So for the first day's observations, I think we're going to be pretty accurate because we have Miss Yolanda to help us.
Compared to yesterday, there was a great diversity in the clouds that we saw.
And I think that's going to be probably the same for the second day. And I think the results are still going to be pretty accurate.
More contrails, lots of people, residential area.
And we have to wait 5 days for NASA to send us back our school data.
I think that looks great.
All right, let's submit.
1, 2, 3.
That is exactly what we needed. A different point of view. From down here at Fang's level, I totally get what he sees in those cups. A place to hang out, like a den, but for a mouse.
I should have known. I love to hang out in weird spaces, too.
Your oddness gives me an idea. Okay, I think we're finally ready to shoot my film. Fang, from the top. And action!
Follow the stick around the cups, little buddy.
Yay! Good boy, Fang!
Miss Yolanda invited us to NASA.
Awesome! I'm so excited!
I thought it was amazing. I never thought as a 14-year-old that I'd get to go to NASA. I thought that was a really amazing experience.
My favorite part was climbing through the wind tunnel.
We're about to take a weather balloon. Right here, we're gonna fill it up with helium, and then we're gonna launch it off into the atmosphere.
Oh my goodness.
Is this where all the measurements are taken?
That's right. This is the little styrofoam box. All the instruments in it that will take temperature, relative humidity, pressure, altitude. It has the radio transmitter that'll send our measurements back down to us here so we can see them soon. It has a lot of information in that little box there.
Three, two, one.
Here's our data coming in. It looks like we've got a good amount of it.
It looks interesting.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
I thought it was very cool that we would be able to chart where the weather balloon goes and saw a graph based on the altitude and the temperature.
Hi, Lynn.
Hi, Yolanda. What are you doing out here?
During our NASA tour, Miss Yolanda introduced us to a scientist named Dr. Lynn Chambers.
So you use our school data?
Yes, we do.
So what do you use our data for?
We use the data to help us to validate the satellite. So we have five satellites right now that are up in orbit that are taking data. It's really important for us. I mean, scientists, there's not that many of us, so having other people help us with the observations in places that we can't really go is very useful.
It was really great that this is actual scientific evidence. It's really cool to be involved in something that is all over the world.
Thank you so much. This has been an amazing day.
So we still have a couple days before your data comes back. In the meantime, I have a contact at the Virginia Air and Space Center, and they've been looking for a good cloud display. You guys could think of some ways to sort of display the different cloud types that you learned this week.
Yeah, that's great.
Hi, my name is Emma, and I volunteer at an animal shelter to help dogs find their forever homes.
I love the beach and surfing.
Thanks for visiting. Welcome to the Virginia Air and Space Center.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, we're excited you're here.
Wow,
we have an Apollo 12 capsule, the Orion test capsule, which is the next spacecraft.
So cool. They had a flight simulator, and then when I was in there with Madison, he was just screaming the whole time.
I think this would be a fantastic spot.
Yeah, me too.
With all the aircraft in the back, and I know you're working on your project, so I wanted to see what you thought about this location.
This will be our cloud wall, and it will wrap around like that, or even if...
Our first wall is going to be a cloud wall, basically a whole layout of the troposphere, and we're going to label the different levels that clouds are found in.
It'd be cool if we did like a giant chalkboard.
Do a mixed media presentation.
Or go home, do a school observation, bring your picture in, and tape it to the wall. That would be cool.
That was great.
Graphics and visuals and handouts.
Draw your own cloud.
We're going to put up the school website and a QR code and then have people scan it when they get to that part of the display.
And I want them to see why we care about the school program, why we care about measuring clouds in the atmosphere, and you know, why should they care, and how could they get involved?
Since we have 2 days till Saturday when we need to present all this, the pressure's really on to get everything done. And I think with such a great team like Maddie and Lauren, it'll be really easy, but it's still a lot of hard work and it's gonna take a lot of thinking. So the pressure was really on.
All right, let's grab what we can.
We're never gonna get this done. It's gonna be one kicking display.
So this is our cloud wall, what we're doing right now. I think we need to separate the layers of the sky. There are many different layers of the atmosphere, yet the troposphere is just a small slice of it, and it is actually the lowest and the smallest level. But this level is where all of our clouds occur.
It doesn't say how high up the troposphere is.
High-level clouds, again, form above 20,000 feet. Mid-level clouds typically have bases between 6,500 to 20,000 feet, and low-level clouds form below 6,500 feet. Now we have a definite range of where the high-level, mid-level, and low-level clouds fall. We can mark those ranges and then just put our clouds in the range where they fall. Because I think that's the most accurate way to do it. I think we're going to need a calculator for this conversion. We estimated the top of the troposphere as being 33,000 feet. We picked up a 12-foot canvas for our cloud wall.
We're painting to make it look like the troposphere.
We then divided 33,000 by 12 feet. Then we divided that by 12 to get inches. That means that every inch on our canvas represents 230 feet in the troposphere.
A scale is a great way for you to represent something that's too big for you to show.
Guys, I think we shouldn't touch it anymore.
Yeah.
It looks good, guys.
My name is Lauren.
Aside from science, I enjoy music and sports. I love to sing and play the piano. And I love to play tennis.
Thanks for watching.
We're all outgoing. Great team, because we can work on multiple tasks at one time. And in the end, everything will look great.
Is that the data?
Yeah, I think it's the data, guys.
Today, we got an email with our observation from our first day.
Hello, Mel. Thank you for your recent school rover cloud observation report.
Remember that matches may not always be perfect.
So Aqua didn't observe any low-level clouds. Some of our observations matched, but the majority didn't.
Yeah, I was so disappointed because I was like, man, our match is going to be so on point.
Knock, knock.
Miss Yolanda.
Hi, ladies. Hi. Come on in.
I was glad to have Miss Yolanda there to tell me, oh, no, it's okay. That's the whole reason to this process.
I actually think it's a better match than you guys maybe think. I think our ground observations help to round out the picture that the satellite saw. Remember how we're looking at the Earth from two different perspectives. There's a satellite looking from space down on Earth, and we're looking from the ground up to space. So it saw more high-level clouds and mid-level clouds, and those probably just covered the low-level clouds, so it was harder to tell. Our observation of the low-level clouds actually gives us a better picture of what the atmosphere actually was that day.
Okay.
So we're actually adding some information to the observations that the satellite saw, so that's really helpful. The next thing that we have to do is share with the school team what we think about how our observations match with what the satellite observed.
All right. High cloud cover matches, but satellite view of lower clouds is blocked. That is correct. So
yeah.
Let's click that one. When Miss Yolanda told us that the data was a lot more helpful than we thought, we were really excited and thrilled.
Do you have all the different cloud labels? Today, it's like, we have to get everything done.
We are now starting to construct our clouds. Fluff for stratus and cotton balls for cumulus.
I think that's a good idea.
I think for the cirrocumulus, if we pulled them out a little bit, it would make them look more like cirrus clouds.
And if we roll them like this, they make good contrails.
Right. We've worked very hard, and I feel that we have everything under our belt. We know our stuff.
Which cloud was like a blanket?
Stratus.
Stratus.
Guys, we should check to see if our data came in.
Yeah, we should.
Let's do it. Our observations from day two are unknown as to where they are.
Nope.
We are patiently or impatiently waiting for them.
I am just putting the finishing touches on our Aqua satellite. So we're just going to be putting these on the school wall because these are the two satellites that collect data.
Rain! Oh, crunch time because we only have a few hours left. Tonight, we will wrap up our display and finalize all the last touches and make sure that everything looks good and has the correct information so that we can hang it tomorrow.
Bring this over here.
Right now, we are putting the finishing touches on our displays. So the parents, families, and friends, they're already here. So the pressure's really on, and I'm really scared.
So they can see like that side and then this side.
Are you guys almost ready? How much tape are you gonna use?
I'll hit it with this.
We're not sure why we haven't gotten the Sunday data back yet, but Yolanda said that there were some technical difficulties with, you know, processing the data and sending it back to us. We're very anxious to get our data back and see if it's a match.
When it does come in, Emma's hopefully going to come back and put it up.
Hi, ladies.
Hi.
Hi, Yolanda. Hi, Dr.
Lynn.
Wow. Look at all this hard work you guys put in.
I think the visitors will be pretty surprised that our troposphere reached heights of 12 feet. That 14-year-olds could make such an awesome display.
Nice. There it is.
It works. It really, really works.
I'm pretty excited that I get to share with the public what I've learned. This is the troposphere.
When I saw what they accomplished in such a small amount of time and all of the experiences they had, I was really blown away.
That is actually a weather balloon. We released it into the sky.
I thought the display was excellent, and they knew their stuff. When you asked them questions, they knew all about it.
Satellites, what they see is the different temperatures of the cloud.
They were actually giving data that NASA was going to be using. I mean, how awesome is that?
Science is actually really interesting once you get into it.
Today went really well. We were able to explain our exhibit to a lot of people. The majority of the responses that we got back were very positive, enthusiastic about what we were doing. I am definitely going to continue with school, or at least try to, because I think it's a great program and I would love to partake in it more and help out and be a better citizen scientist.
Yeah! Yes, good job.
Jake, I'm a finalist. I can't believe it. They love my short film.
That's awesome, Iz. Told you Fang was destined to be a star.
Yeah, thanks for letting me borrow him. He was a hit.
No problem. Know what else is a hit?
Lint-age cheese?
Close, but nope. Me. Fang will always be my biggest fan, and I'll always be his.
Aw, that's adorable. Let's say it again so I can film it.
Even though there are a lot of people at the beach, it's still kind of like peaceful because you're like in your own little world at the beach.
I love studying clouds because they're always so beautiful and they're almost a form of natural art, and I'm kind of like an art buff.
It's really nice to just lie there, observe the sky, and chill.
Thank you.